Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem which is based on hypothetical air cycle. Here is the question. It is given that in a hypothetical air cycle, which we can say that it is an imaginary cycle consisting of three processes, an adiabatic compression is followed by an isothermal expansion to the initial volume of compression. Finally, a heat rejection process completes the cycle. It means in this cycle there are three processes: adiabatic compression, isothermal expansion, and then initial volume of compression, means it is constant volume compression process. Next, finally a heat rejection process completes the cycle. So the question is, draw the cycle on PV and TS diagrams and derive an expression for thermal efficiency of the cycle in terms of compression ratio, which is denoted by small r. So at first we are going to draw the PV and TS diagram and find the efficiency for this hypothetical cycle. Next, also find the efficiency of the cycle if the compression ratio is 14 and intake pressure and temperature are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. So here, after deriving the formula for efficiency, we have to calculate the efficiency if compression ratio is given and intake pressure and temperatures are given as 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. Take for air, the specific heat at constant pressure and constant volumes are given. So I'll write all this in the form of data first. Let us get started. Now the type of the cycle is, it is an hypothetical cycle. Now hypothetical cycles are imaginary cycles. They are in such a way that the processes which are used here, it cannot be followed in a practical manner. So hypothetical cycle can be said to be an imaginary or a theoretical cycle, which is, you can say that this cycle would be something which is not practically possible. Hypothetical, imaginary cycle. Now, so here in the hypothetical air cycle, it consists of three processes which are given here. I'll note down the processes. So process 1 to 2 is adiabatic compression. Next, process 2 to 3, isothermal heat addition. And at last, there is constant volume heat rejection. So after these processes, we have to draw the PV and TS diagram, derive the equation. Compression ratio is given as 14, which is R suffix C, that is 14. Intake pressure is P1 is equal to 1 bar, that is 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. The intake temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. So that will be 300 Kelvin. Next, take for air, specific heats are given. At constant pressure, it is 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Then CV value is 0.718 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And here we have to find the efficiency of the cycle. So I am going to calculate the efficiency for this hypothetical cycle. Now this is the data which is available to us. With the data available in the question understood, let us try to get the solution to this problem. In the solution part, first I'll say that drawing PV, that is pressure volume, and TS, temperature entropy diagram, for the given hypothetical cycle. Now in this PV and TS diagram, first I'll start with the PV diagram. The first process is adiabatic compression, and it can be shown on PV diagram with the help of a curve. This is process 1-2. At point number 1, the volume is V1. At point 2, the volume is V2, and it follows the law PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, that is for reversible adiabatic process. Now in this process we can see that during the compression process, volume goes on decreasing from V1 to V2, but pressure increases from P1 to P2. So here during the reversible adiabatic, or we can say isentropic process, the volume will decrease and pressure will increase, so it is a compression process. Next, there is isothermal heat addition process, and for that now, as I have drawn adiabatic curve, next thing would be to draw the isothermal line. Isothermal line . So this is the isothermal process from point 2 to 3. Here I'll write down that it means PV is equal to constant, which is the isothermal process. And here, as I have extended this V1, the reason for this extension was from 3 to 1, the heat rejection is at constant volume. So from 3 to 1, the volume will remain constant, V1 is equal to V3. So this is the constant volume heat rejection. So heat is added during the process 2 to 3 and we get expansion. So this is heat added. Heat is rejected during the process 3 to 1, which is at constant volume. During process 1 to 2, we have to give input work as compression, because we want to compress the gases, or here we can say it is air. So this is the complete PV diagram. Next, I'll draw the TS diagram for this cycle. Now in case of TS diagram, as the first process is reversible adiabatic or isentropic compression, it will be shown on the TS diagram with the help of a vertical line. From process 1 to 2, the entropy will remain constant, S1 is equal to S2, and temperature will increase from T1 to T2. So this is the isentropic compression process on TS diagram. So now here I have denoted the isentropic process on TS diagram. Next, 2 to 3 is constant temperature, or we can say here isothermal heat addition process, so temperature should remain constant from point 2 to 3, but entropy is increasing, because heat is being added, so entropy increases. Here the entropy is S3. Next, there is constant volume heat rejection, which will be shown on TS diagram with the help of an inclined line. Now this line I'll extend, this is a constant volume line, and here the volume of 0.1 and 0.3 both are same because they lie on the same constant volume line. So heat gets added during process 2 to 3, it is rejected from 3 to 1, and there is work input during compression. So now this is the PV and TS diagram for the hypothetical cycle which was given in the question. Now after reaching here, I'll analyze the processes one by one, starting with first, that is process 1 to 2. So from process 1 to 2, since it is reversible adiabatic, also called as isentropic process, here the relation can be written as T2 upon T1 is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. Now this relation can be written for reversible adiabatic or isentropic process. Now V1 by V2, if we see here, V1 is called as the cylinder volume, V2 is called as clearance volume. So V1 by V2 is nothing but compression ratio. So here I'll say that where V1 by V2 is equal to R, which is nothing but compression ratio, and it is given by cylinder volume upon clearance volume. So I'll replace V1 by V2 with R. So this will become, therefore T2 will be equal to T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1, and here I'll keep this as equation first. Next, we can also say that during the process 1 to 2, which is called as isentropic compression process, since it is reversible adiabatic, so in case of reversible adiabatic process, it is considered as a process in which the heat transfer is zero. So here I can say that for the process 1 to 2, heat transfer during process 1 to 2, that is equal to zero, since it is reversible adiabatic or isentropic process. Next, after reaching at this stage, that is for process 1 to 2, now I use the second process. For process 2 to 3, which is isothermal heat addition, so during this process, since it is isothermal heat addition, temperature of point number 2 and point 3 both are same, so T2 will be equal to T3. I'll write it down that T2 is equal to T3 since it is isothermal process. Next, therefore in case of isothermal process, here I can say that, I'll explain it here, for isothermal process, since heat transfer is given by work done plus change in internal energy, and now that change in internal energy is nothing but it is MCV, the difference of temperature, here this will be T3 minus T2, and since T2 and T3 both are same, so if I replace T3 with T2, so T2 minus T2 will give me 0, similarly for T2, so delta U will become 0. It means in case of isothermal process, the amount of heat transfer is equal to the amount of work done, that is whatever the heat is given, it is utilized in the form of work, and the total internal energy will be zero for isothermal process. So here I can say that therefore Q is equal to work done, and work done for isothermal process, it is given by the formula, that is it will be M R T2 into ln of R, where R is nothing but compression ratio, because this will be R, it will be V3 by V2, and V3 as we see here, V3 is equal to V1, so again V1 by V2, that is nothing but compression ratio. And next I'll say that let mass M, mass of air, equal to 1 kg. So the formula reduces to, I'll write down, this is the heat transfer during the process 2 to 3, and it will be R into T2 into ln of R. Now keeping this as equation number second, next after reaching here I'll go on to the next process, that is process 2 to 3, or we can say for process 3 to 1. So for process 3 to 1, which is constant volume heat rejection process. So now process 3 to 1 is constant volume heat rejection process. I'll write that heat rejection. It is there in process 3 to 1. So therefore it will be Q suffix 3 to 1, and the formula is MCV, it is T3 minus T1, and here as mass we have assumed it to be 1 kg, so therefore this will become Q 3 to 1 is equal to CV into T3 minus T1 since mass M is equal to 1 kg. Now after getting the heat rejection, previously we have got heat addition, which was isothermal heat addition. Now I'll write the formula of efficiency, because we have to derive the efficiency for this hypothetical air cycle. So therefore efficiency of hypothetical air cycle, it will be given by efficiency is equal to work done upon heat supplied or heat added. And now work done is nothing but, it is heat added minus heat rejected, so I'll write the formula in this way, heat added minus heat rejected upon heat added. So therefore efficiency will become, heat addition is during process 2 to 3, so Q suffix 2 to 3, minus heat rejection is from 3 to 1, Q 3 to 1, then heat addition is from 2 to 3, so it is Q 2 to 3. So finally the formula will become, therefore efficiency will be equal to 1 minus Q 3 to 1 upon Q 2 to 3, because this 2 to 3 and 2 to 3 will get cancelled out, so here it remains minus Q 3 to 1 upon Q 2 to 3. So therefore putting the values, 1 minus Q 3 to 1, that we have found out, it is CV T3 minus T1 Q 2 to 3, it is R T2 into ln of R, that is from equation 2, therefore this efficiency here will be equal to 1 minus CV. Now instead of T3 I'll put the value that T3 is equal to T2 and the value of T2 is T1 R raised to gamma minus 1. So instead of T3 it will be T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1 minus T1 divided by R into, instead of T2 here again I'll put the value T1 R raised to gamma minus 1 into ln of R, and that is from equation number 1. Next, 1 minus CV, I'll take T1 common, so into the bracket we have R raised to gamma minus 1 minus 1 divided by, here we have R into T1 R raised to gamma minus 1 into ln of R. Next, T1 will get cancelled out, so we have 1 minus CV upon, I'll keep this term R ln R together, and into the bracket we have R raised to gamma minus 1 minus 1 divided by R raised to gamma minus 1, this term which is left. So finally, if I simplify this, R raised to gamma minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1, that will get cancelled out, so 1 remains, minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. So the formula of efficiency for hypothetical cycle which is an imaginary cycle, it is equal to 1 minus CV R ln small r, which is the compression ratio, into bracket 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1 . So here I can say that equation number capital A, it gives the formula for efficiency of this hypothetical cycle in the form of compression ratio, which is R. So the first part is done. Next, we have to find the efficiency value, and for that I'll calculate first the value of temperature T2, because it would be required in the further part. So I'll say that therefore from equation 1 we have T2 is equal to T1 into R raised to gamma minus 1. Now for gamma, I'll say that since Cp minus Cv, that is equal to R, and here in this problem they have given Cp Cv values, so R also can be calculated. So R will be, Cp is 1.005, CV is 0.718, so R value is equal to 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and gamma is nothing but CP upon CV. CP is 1.005, CV 0.718. Therefore, gamma is 1.4. So here the calculation part I have shown for R and gamma. So gamma value can be put here. Therefore, T2 will be equal to T1 value. T1 is 300 Kelvin and RC is nothing but R, which is compression ratio. So it is 14, so 300 into 14 raised to 1.4 minus 1. Therefore, T2 is equal to 862 Kelvin, and that will also be equal to T3 because of the isothermal process from 2 to 3. Next, after getting this, I'll say that therefore heat addition is given by, now heat addition which is during process 2 to 3, it is equal to here we have RT2 into ln of R, that is from equation second. So here the value of R, it is 0.287, T2 is 862, ln of R which is 14. So here Q223, it comes out to be 652.88 kilojoule per kg. So here I've got the value of heat added. Now I'll get the value of heat rejected. So therefore heat is rejected from 3 to 1. So hence Q3 to 1 is equal to CV T3 minus T1, because mass is 1 kg and heat is added at constant volume. So this will be equal to, so now here I'll put the values, CV 0.718, T3 is equal to T2, that is 862 Kelvin, minus T1 value is 300. So from this I'll get the value of heat rejected, which is Q3 to 1, and my answer is 403.52 kilojoule per kg. After getting the amount of heat rejected, we can find the efficiency by using the concept that efficiency for the cycle is 1 minus heat rejected, which is Q3 to 1, upon heat supplied, which is Q2 to 3. So I'll use this concept. Therefore, efficiency of hypothetical cycle is given by so putting the values, heat rejected Q3 to 1 is 403.52, heat added was 652.88. so from this I'll get the answer as 0.3819 or 38.19% if I multiply it by 100. So this is the answer of efficiency of hypothetical cycle. And here if we see the question, the question was to calculate or draw the cycle on PV and TS diagram and derive the expression for thermal efficiency of the cycle in terms of expression R, which is the compression ratio. So we have drawn the PV and TS diagram and found the efficiency of hypothetical cycle in terms of compression ratio R. So first part was over. And also find the efficiency of the cycle if compression ratio is 14 and intake conditions were given. So for that, we have found out the efficiency of the hypothetical cycle under the given conditions, and it comes out to be 38.19%. And with this, we complete the problem.